I'm Christina Bellantoni, NewsHour political editor, and we are here with Jon Ward, senior reporter with the Huffington Post, to talk about the South Carolina special House election for the 1st Congressional District. Now, you might hear all of those words and think, why would we care about a special House election? But this is actually a really interesting race in a state that's been fairly conservative, and the election is Tuesday. And Jon was in South Carolina over the weekend and for a couple days before that. So what's the general lay of the land here, and why should people care about it?
Sure. So I think the basic reason people will care about it is the fact that you've got a former governor of the state, Mark Sanford, who in 2009 disappeared,
right,
and then reappeared and told the
not
world.
Not like magic, but like actually
right,
left
his staff
town.
Didn't know where he was. And he told the nation, who had begun to pay attention to this, you know, story, that he had not been hiking the Appalachian Trail as he had told his staff. He was in Argentina having an affair. And so he has since left politics,
right,
and then is trying to make a comeback. He's running against Elizabeth Colbert Bush, who is Stephen Colbert's younger sister.
Right.
I'm sorry. I can't remember if she's older or younger. I got that wrong in my story. We had to correct it.
Oh, no.
She's 58. I know that.
Okay.
So I think she's older.
That sounds older, but we'll check that.
Yes.
So to back up just a minute with Sanford, this used to be his congressional seat. How do people feel about him in the district? What are you seeing when you see him out shaking hands?
It was a mix. I mean, you had some people who gave him sort of a dirty look, you know, like, oh, there's that guy who cheated on his wife. But you also have people who have a more libertarian take. They feel like that's his business, I don't care. And then you have sort of a third group that feels like he betrayed the public trust by, you know, using government money to go to Argentina at times. And those three categories sometimes mix, and it's not cut and dry. It's not like people are all going to say, I don't like what he did, therefore I won't vote for him. There are some people who don't like what he did who will still probably end up voting for him because it's a conservative district.
Right. And his former wife, Jenny Sanford, the former First Lady of the state, there's been all kinds of dust-ups there. She was his campaign manager years ago when he held this district. Where does she stand now? Has she endorsed anybody in this race?
She has not. But in my conversation with Sanford on, I think it was Thursday afternoon, we had a 45-minute conversation at a bar table in a little town called Bluffton, South Carolina, near Hilton Head. And he kept sort of intimating, sometimes on the record, sometimes off the record. He wanted to go off the record a bunch of times. But he clearly feels like she is sort of undermining him. You know, he kind of throws in these hints that she's the one who leaked the court documents about her complaints of trespassing against him for coming to her house. So he feels like she is working against him. It seems like a very complicated relationship because in the interviews I've seen of her over the past years, she's not outright hostile to him. She says he's a good dad to his boys and has, you know, some kind words for him. So it's an interesting sort of personal dynamic.
Sure. It gets complicated. So the Elizabeth Colbert Bush, she is Stephen Colbert's sister, and that's how you hear most people describe
right.
her. She's gotten a lot of national attention fundraising. But what else about her? What makes her qualified to be a member of Congress? What is she out there saying? She's not out there saying she's a famous person's sister.
No,
right?
She's not. Although at one point, I believe they did have a hashtag going for their campaign, Stephen's sister.
Yeah.
But on her bus, it says Elizabeth means business. The podium or the rostrum, the sign says just means business. Didn't even have her name. So she's clearly running as a businesswoman, somebody who is running on her credentials to get the economy going. She has a background in working with the University of Clemson, trying to hook them up with the corporate sector and money. She has background in working in ports. She's been in South Carolina a lot of her life. And so that's the direction she's going. The question is, are voters going to look closer than just superficially at her record? Because they probably won't like her positions on stuff like Obamacare and other things.
So this district had been fairly strongly Republican. Polls show it just about tied, is that right?
Yeah, about 2 weeks ago, they had the allegations of trespassing that came out. There was a PPP poll that showed Colbert Bush up by 9 or 10 points.
Right.
Since then, all the polls show it dead heat.
Wow. So this election is Tuesday. We're going to be paying lots of attention to it. We'll be paying attention to your reporting. And we can follow you on Twitter where? Give your handle to our friends.
JONWARD11.
That's great. Thanks very much, Jon Ward.
Thanks.
And stay tuned.